everyone. Hope you've been well and you're keeping safe. This is just another one of my vlogs, just giving you an update on what's happening with Bristol and COVID, some real developments over recent days, what with the Prime Minister's winter plan being released. So we just want to keep you up to speed with what we are doing in Bristol. So our case rate of infection at the moment is 261 per 100,000 people. This compares to 375 cases per 100,000 this time last week. So you'll remember we were cautious over a period of time because we plateaued as a city, but it's very good to see that case rate beginning to fall. That should not lead to premature overconfidence. That's still a very high background rate, meaning the virus is out there circulating in the population. There were 1,216 people in Bristol tested positive for coronavirus this week. The England rate, case rate at the moment is 308. And while I'm not pleased that it's high across England as a whole, it's good news for Bristol in that from being above that rate, we are now below it. And a piece of sobering news, there are now 116 people in our hospitals unwell with COVID-19. That is an increase. Certainly the vaccine has weakened the relationship between COVID and hospitalization, but it's not broken that link. So the risk is still very real. On the front, 77% of people over the age of 16 have had one dose of a vaccine. 69% over the age of 16 have had two doses of a vaccine. Again, those percentages are going up, but they are not as high as we would ideally like them to be. So please, if you have not had your vaccination and you are able to do so, and there's no underlying medical reason why you shouldn't, please do go and get your vaccination. It's a way of keeping you safe, keeping others safe, and relieving the pressure on the National Health Service. So although it's good that our rate of infection rate has decreased, as I said, the virus is still with us. The UK chief medical officers have now advised that healthy children aged 12 to 15 should get one dose of COVID-19. The COVID-19 vaccine. Locally, we will begin offering children aged 12 to 15 one dose of the vaccination from the week commencing the 20th of September. Most vaccinations will be given in a school setting. We'll also provide community clinics for young people who are unable to attend school-based clinics. Parents and carers will be asked to give consent for their children to have the COVID-19 vaccine. Your child's school or local authority, in that case us, will be in touch shortly with more information about this and a link to an online consent form. Of course, paper consent forms will also be made available. Now, I mentioned that the top end, the Prime Minister's COVID winter plan, was announced. This is there to set out support for the National Health Service and to stem the spread of COVID-19 this winter. It focuses heavily on the national vaccination campaign and an effort to ensure that as many people as possible are protected throughout the colder months. Obviously, it's going to fall to local authorities to really do the heavy lifting of offering that protection. And I really want to thank those city partners who have really come together under our One City approach historically and will continue to do so to make sure that we're making, doing everything we can to keep people as safe as possible. Government have announced that next week the national COVID booster jab program will begin. That includes all of those over the age of 50 and those aged 16 and over, with underlying health conditions. And people will be offered a booster jab no earlier than 6 months after their primary vaccine course. The NHS will contact you when it's time to get your booster. You do not need to contact the National Health Service to initiate that. It's important that we all continue to look out for one another during these colder months, getting back to those basic behaviours of hand, face and space can help to reduce the spread of coronavirus, as well as the other seasonal illnesses like flu that we are a real, real risk of seeing a resurgence of and will themselves add pressure to our health services. So remember, a mild illness for you could be a very serious illness for someone else. So please take care of each other, be gracious to each other, and stay safe.